Many players are wondering why Battlefield 1 didn't get the fixes and changes made in Battlefield 4 that improved the game. The discussion of that topic started right after BF1 was released and players started noticing that we have issues that were already solved in previous titles. And before I start getting comments saying that I'm copying Level Cap's ideas for videos, yes, I got inspired by his video that was posted yesterday, but mine is not even going to be similar to his. Alright, so back to the main question. Why did Battlefield 1 not receive updates and changes that were already implemented to the game in BF4? The first basic thing that you need to understand about game design is that creating a game, especially one like Battlefield, takes a long time. So let's say that Battlefield 1's lifetime started in the October 2016, when the game was released. In this point in time, the lifetime of the game started for us, the customers, because then we were able to buy the game and play it. And now there is this tricky thing about the whole situation, because in reality, for developers and DICE Studio in general, the lifetime of Battlefield 1 started at least 2 years before that. And I'm saying at least, because I can only speculate how long did it take them to actually create the whole game from the scratch. One certain thing though is that Battlefield 1 was in playable state 1 year before it got released. And why is all this so important? Let's pretend it took DICE 2 years to design BF1, which I think was a lot longer process anyway, but for the purpose of this video, let's say it was 2 exact years. If you go 2 years back, from the date of Battlefield 1 getting released, then we end up in the middle of Battlefield 4 life cycle. And this is only if we take into the consideration that designing Battlefield 1 took exactly 2 years, which, as I already stated, was a lot longer process. Most of you are probably wondering, where's the catch? What's the big deal about it? Well, the whole thing is that Battlefield 1 was being designed while Battlefield 4 was being fixed. Those were going at the same time. Another important thing in this whole discussion is that DICE LA took over BF4 from DICE Sweden somewhere in the middle of Battlefield 4 lifetime. The official statement is that LA team is taking over to fix issues and generally fix the game. Well, that was the official statement. Because LA could have easily gotten BF4 just because Sweden started focusing on creating one. I'm not saying this is 100% certain, those are just my speculations at this point. But one thing certainly did happen. The exact same set of events went off in BF1. DICE Sweden created the game, then DICE LA took it over, somewhere in the middle of its life cycle, and now LA team is responsible for it. So what if all this isn't about current Battlefield title on the market, but about a future game being created? So now going back to the beginning, imagine that you have two separate timelines. One is for Battlefield 1, and the second one is for Battlefield 4. At the point in time when Battlefield 4 was getting fixed by DICE LA, Battlefield 1 was already being created by DICE Sweden. So the answer to the question, why those fixes weren't carried over from 4 to 1, is because they haven't been created yet. And I know that you could argue that they should have just implemented them later when they had time and those fixes already existed. I'm not trying to defend them or justify what they did, but the one thing is certain. They wanted the best launch of Battlefield ever, because after failing with Battlefield 4 launch, it was kind of, you either do it and sell the product, or you go down. And believe me, that changing so many core gameplay things in the game is just time consuming and it takes resources. Once again, I'm not justifying them, I'm just giving you the perspective of the gamer who's been there for like 5 or 6 years with the franchise. And that would be it for the topic of fixes going from BF4 to BF1. Many of you guys are asking about the events and PTFO missions going on during the Battlefest, and while they're not active now, or they're not posted yet at the time when I'm recording this video, I will most likely post them in the comments, and those are always available on my Twitter, because I tweet stuff almost all the time, so like you don't need to wait 24 hours for the new video, just follow me there and you will get notified instantly if the new assignments come out. And as always guys, if you enjoyed, remember to leave a like, subscribe, and I see you on the battlefield!